with robots getting more and more present in our daily lives, it's interesting to look back and get to know the great minds who first dreamt of a future where machines would help humans. Let's take a look at three great minds who are considered the fathers of robotics. Born in Russia in 1920, Isaac Asimov was a prolific American writer with more than 500 books published, and is one of the greatest science fiction writers of all time. Growing up in Brooklyn, he demonstrated early the signs of a bright mind and an appetite for reading. At the age of 11, he started writing his own stories and was selling them before he turned 90. Pursuing a degree in chemistry, he earned his PhD in 1948. He eventually became a professor before switching to full-time writing in 1958. In his robot series, Asimov built a universe and unified history promoting the themes of interaction between humans, robots, and morality. The series would give birth to two important concepts, positronic robots and robotics, and get him the credit for inventing the word robotics. And not only did he coin the term, he also wrote its fundamental rules. Introduced in 1942, the three laws of robotics define the core principles of modern robotics. Law number 1. A robot may not injure a human being, or through inaction, allow a human being to come to harm. Law number 2. A robot must obey the orders given it by human beings, except where such orders would conflict with the first law. Law number 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second laws. These laws would move beyond the realm of Asimov's words, becoming science fiction postulate and even the basics for robotics design, or any other tool. Asimov did more than just create the concept of robotics and define its rules. He also opened our eyes to what could be the future of technology and of humanity. As one of the most prolific authors, his books influenced so many things and people that without him, our world would be very different, and robotics will surely not be where it is today. Born in Brooklyn in 1925, Joseph was an American physicist, engineer, and entrepreneur. Growing up in Connecticut during the Great Depression, he returned to New York City for his college education. He pursued degrees in physics and electric engineering from Columbia University. He met George Duval, a colleague and owner of a patent for a basic industrial robotic arm in 1956. When the company they worked for closed their division, finding themselves without a job but with an idea, they founded the world's first robotics company, Unimate. The two men collaborated to design and produce a robotic arm based on Devol's patent. They installed the first unit of the Unimate robotic arm at the General Motors plant in New Jersey in 1961. The arm completely disrupted the car manufacturing industry. Chrysler and Ford soon followed General Motors and started deploying Unimate arms in their manufacturing facilities. 5 years later, Engelberger and a Unimate robots were guests on The Tonight Show. After leaving Unimate in the 80s and seeing his parents age, Engelberger saw an opportunity for robotics to improve the medical field. He founded Transitions Research Corporation in 1984, selling the first HelpMate robot unit in 1988. Within the next 10 years, over 100 hospitals worldwide were operating HelpMate. Even after leaving his company and being in his 80s, he remained a very active member in the field and in the community. Joseph Engelberger surpassed himself to develop his companies and democratize robots. He always strived to improve his company's products and to ensure they provided a positive impact on the world and on human lives. Committed to his vision, he kept working until his last years. His work disrupted our world, and he did so while following a humanist vision of a better world where robots will improve human lives. Born during the Islamic Golden Age, Ismail Al-Jazari was a polymath. He was simultaneously a scholar, an inventor, a mechanical engineer, an artisan, an artist, and a mathematician. Despite his work traversing the ages, almost nothing is known about his personal life. The year of his death, he published the Book of Knowledge of Ingenious Mechanical Devices, which is considered among the first instances of the do-it-yourself philosophy. Indeed, Ismail Al-Jazari was more interested in the craftsmanship necessary to build a mechanical device rather than in the theory or the technology behind it. His book gathers 100 devices he built and the instructions to build them. He was inspired by previous works of other inventors and makers, which he tried to improve upon. While the inventions might appear trivial today, the mechanisms and ideas he featured are quite significant. From crankshafts to segmental gear, many inventions included revolutionary mechanism. While everyone is aware of Da Vinci's legacy and genius, very few know that he was inspired by Al-Jazari's work and inventions. He built many automated mechanisms, such as moving peacocks powered by hydropower and the first automatic gates and doors. The impact Al-Jazari had on robotics has been described as revealing an interest in manipulating the environment for human comfort, and that its greatest contribution was the concept of practical application. One of his most elaborate robots was a musical robot band. It was a boat that floated on the lake and entertaining guests with four robot musicians on board. It's also among the first programmable automata. You could define the drum smash in rhythms and patterns using pegs. Centuries before modern robotics and computers, Ismail Al-Jazari was building the first automated device and was among the first to introduce the concept of programming. Despite being relatively unknown to the general public, he can and should be considered as one of the fathers of robotics, as well as one of the do-it-yourself and maker philosophies. Thanks for watching! We hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share it.